Ezekiel Elliott had his fifth 100-yard rushing game of the season last night, and third in a row. The 24-year-old All-Pro didn't find the end zone, but he did average six yards a carry in the Cowboys' 37-18 win. On the flip side, 22-year-old Saquon Barkley had a tough go against the Cowboys' defense, averaging just 2 yards a carry. Saquon did pull in 6 catches for 67 yards, but also failed to find the end zone. So, Shannon, which running back would you take moving forward, Zeke or Saquon?
Put him on 11 player field. I'm taking Saquon. You saw the difference. You showed the highlight. Zeke is not even getting touched till he's 13, 14 yards in the backfield. I mean, beyond the line of scrimmage. Okay. And you look at Saquon, he's got 2 guys hitting him before he can get to the line of scrimmage. Skip, I think it goes back to the old adage. I remember the who would you take, Emmitt Smith or Barry Sanders? Well, you put Saquon behind that offensive line that the Cowboys have, and you're going to see things. I believe Saquon would have 200 to 300 more yards because he's more explosive. People don't realize this. Saquon is the bigger of the two men. We've had Saquon sit right next to us, Skip, and we could not believe just how big he actually is. Sure. He's 230-plus pounds, probably closer to 235, and he can accelerate. You watched him on that screen, that's what you've been wanting to see from Zeke. He put his foot in the dirt, yong, gone.
Although I was a little surprised he didn't outrun everybody. Well, usually he's just gone, gone.
Skip, Skip, you watch this angle. He's running. Look at Sean Lee. Sean Lee said, I quit. Look at this. Look at Byron Jones.
Okay. But look at Xavier Woods catches him.
No, he's trying to set up a block. Okay. That's the only reason Xavier Woods.
Because
remember, he ran past Xavier Woods. Xavier Woods was out there to begin with.
Yeah.
I'm going to take Saquon because I believe he can bang like Zeke because he's a big guy, bigger guy than Zeke. He has more home run potential. I believe he's a more of a threat that when the ball is in his hands, to hit his head on the goalpost. Mm. So if you put these guys on a level playing field, I'm taking Saquon Barkley because I believe he's the better of the two backs. And, Skip, guess what I can do at the end of the night?
What?
I can power my phone off. Mm. That's what I can do.
You got me there.
Yeah.
I'll give you that.
Hard to argue.
If we're just talking about football players, if we're talking about on the field, I'm taking Ezekiel Elliott all day and all night, every night. Except after hours. I'll give you after hours. But if we're talking about football, last night was vintage, classic, what I don't love about Saquon. Because I give you his size, his stature, his thighs. He just doesn't run with the bang that my guy runs with.
Skip, look,
I don't see bang in him.
Skip, your guy was not getting touched until he got to the safeties.
Okay, remember you said that because you're always telling me that they go as Zeke goes.
Yeah, you saw that last night.
The guy I'm seeing now, Ezekiel Elliott, his long run last night was 19 yards,
sure.
But he has lost that breakaway burst that he used to have. I thought he had it as a rookie. I thought he had it as a sophomore in the NFL. He really had it at the Ohio State.
Yeah.
But he doesn't have that. Now he's more of a fullback of a halfback. Now he's more Earl Campbell than Barry Sanders.
Well, Gary Brown is running his position coach said it, Skip. He's more of a body puncher.
Yeah,
he's not a knockout artist. Saquon Barkley is a knockout artist because he'll get you 2, 3, -1, and then hit his head on the goalpost from 70.
But Zeke is a battering ram. He is a sledgehammer of a back who can impose his killer will on you because he's got killer will that I do not see in Saquon Barkley. And last night, if you look at the numbers, what I've told you this now for 2 years. This is Saquon. And again, I'm in awe of his breakaway, his acceleration speed because it's just breathtaking.
Yes.
But last night, he carried the ball 14 times for a grand total of 28 yards with a long of 8 yards. He caught 6 balls for 67 yards with a long of 65. And obviously, they let him loose one time for 65 yards.
Right.
So if we take the take away the 65, look what he did on 30 touches. It's horrendously bad, right?
But Skip, what you're criticizing him for is what you say Zeke can't do. Get the home run. Mm-hmm. Bobby, so what do you want? There are very few guys that can bang. E.D. could bang, but E.D. wasn't the Earl Campbell. E.D. could hit his head on the goalpost. And sometimes, Skip, and that's what Zeke would do. He'll give you 3, 5, 3, 5, 10. Now, come fourth quarter, those 3 and 5 turn to 10, 15, 20 because we don't want to tackle him anymore. Saquon, Skip, those holes that Zeke had, Saquon would have had 200 yards.
Okay, but he didn't have 200 yards.
No.
Because I don't see him run between the tackles the way Zeke can run through the tackles.
Hell, I want to run between those tackles. I can get 56 yards.
You know and I know, Zeke can make his own holes on occasion. Mm-hmm. He can just carry the whole pile with him, which he did a couple times last night.
Why did he do that against the Rams in the playoff game, remember?
Well, I don't know.
You see? Yeah. You say he can carry the pile.
Okay, so why didn't your guy, your escape artist, he had on 19 touches other than the one for 65, yes. He had a grand total of 30 yards.
Yes.
That's 19 touches for 30 yards. Well, that's a 1.6 yard average. That's no good.
Skip, but I tell you, that's what he is. I mean, if you're a knockout artist, you're going to swing sometimes and miss. It's the connect. Mm. That will get you up out of there. Mm. It's the 65 yards that shows you the explosiveness, mm-hmm. that shows you the acceleration. You see the difference? I mean, we watched, I don't know if you saw it, Kansas City, when Damian Williams broke free. And from a dead standstill.
Got run down.
And they asked Tyreek, why did he do that? He said, because he had been bragging that he could outrun me.
By the way, I looked it up, and Damian from the University of Oklahoma ran 4.4 at the combine. Wow. So we're talking about... Listen, 4.4 is fast.
But 4.4 is fast. But you talking about a guy running sub 4.3?
Yes. 4.2-ish.
Yeah.
I mean, that looked like 4.2.
And he said if he had 5 more yards, I'd have took the ball from him and ran it in myself. Okay. But, so you see, Skip, Julio ran 4.3. But you see the difference between Julio mm-hmm. and Tyreek's acceleration. Zeke ran 4.4. But that 4.3 that Barkley can run, you see the difference in acceleration, Skip. And that's what I would take.
Okay, but... Saquon, as much as I respect what he is, he's a great kid, and I give you all the intangible part of it, but he's still just the icing on your cake. He's the strawberries on your cream.
Yeah, you know,
the cream on your strawberries.
Yeah, but Zeke is a straw. Yeah. He's stirring the drink.
Okay.
I've been telling you that. He's been stirring the drink. Yeah, I'm glad you finally come
back. How can you stir the drink when you have gaping holes all night?
Now you got gaping holes.
That's what you just told me.
He does.
And he
did. I didn't lie.
There were, I don't know, 8 or 10 times I'm like, wow.
Well, I'm using what you said against me. Yeah. You said you could have got 5 to 6 yards behind the offensive line that Emmitt was running behind.
Okay. Well, last night, I could have gotten 5 or 6, 7.
You could have.
I might have paid a severe price.
Yeah, you could have.
I got tackled. But I could have gotten 5 or 6.
You got 5 or 6 probably once or twice.
Okay. I promise you that. So what I love about Zeke is he's got that killer in him. He's got it's that killer will where he can just wear you down psychologically where you don't want to mess with him anymore. He's like that black cat on the field. That thing looked like it had a snarl to it.
Hey, you know that, he was that cat, and that cat looking around, ain't nobody rushing. He said, I wish y'all might.
But he wasn't smiling.
No, he was just sitting there. He's like, I wish y'all would come up here and try to get some of this fire.
But he had a snarl to it.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's Zeke running with the football where you're like, I don't know if I want to mess with this guy after a while. But Saquon, they messed with him all night. They're not afraid.
But you
just don't let him get out of the blocks.
I hate Saquon. I hate when great backs play on bad football teams because we don't get an opportunity to really see, especially when they have marginal quarterback play.
Yep.
Because that, I believe that hurt ED a lot. When you play with the quarterbacks that he played with, and they know you're going to get the ball.
Yep.
And Skip, when you fall behind, it really takes the running back out of the game because we don't have that type of an offense. So now they're throwing, and we got to find a way. There was a situation last night, Skip, where Daniel Jones threw the ball out of the end zone, but Saquon snuck out of the backfield. If he'd have just dumped it down, he could have got a first down.
I know the play you're talking about, and he probably would have.
Do you like Saquon or Byron Jones? Yeah. Do you believe Byron Jones is going to be able to stop Saquon from getting a first down to the end zone? That's the difference. That's what I'm talking about.
I got to tell you, Byron Jones is really good.
Yeah, but
he's really athletic.
Yeah.
I would give him a chance.
To get drug into the end zone?
No, I don't know.
But look, They're two phenomenal backs, and Zeke went to the great situation, Skip. And you remember, they built this offense especially for Zeke. They had Ty Smith. They had Zach Martin. And now they got Travis Frederick, Lyle Collins. They took Williams. I mean, really, if you look, Lyle Collins had that, whatever happened to him, had that not been circulating, Skip, he'd have been a first-round draft pick. He was thought so highly of. Jerry gave him $1 million for an undrafted free agent, which is unheard of.
That's true.
Maybe $30,000, maybe even $100,000.
I agree.
But a mil?
Okay.
But that's what he got, and they took Connor Williams in the second round.
Yep.
So you got the potential of 4 first-rounders. It's kind of like the Colts, what they did with their offensive line to protect Andrew Luck. They built this line to run the football and to protect Tony Romo, where Tony got hurt, you know, sliding, running for the first down, got kneed in the back, and he really never played again. But this offense is built tailor-made for Zeke.
Okay.
And he's taking full advantage of it.
Ezekiel Elliott is the definition of establish the run. Saquon is the definition of game breaker. But again, if you can corral him, if you spy him, if you have something, like Sean Lee was just, he just was assigned to Saquon in the second half.
Right.
And every time they tried to screen to him, except for the 65-yarder, who was all over him before he could even get out of the blocks.
And another thing, Skip, a lot has to do with the quarterback play.
Sure.
Is that when you got decent quarterback play, they like, Daniel Jones can't beat us. The one guy that can beat us is 26. We're going to neutralize him. If we neutralize him, we beat them. Skip, you can stack the line, because if you stack the line against Emmitt, Troy and Michael was going to pick you apart, and then they might throw the home run over the top to Alvin Harper.
How many times have you seen Zeke power it up between the tackles, like almost right over center, and get 5 yards that you say, there is no hole there?
Would there have been
times? He just made his own hole.
He does, Skip. Okay? There are times they have him in the backfield that what should be a 1 to 2 yard loss, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage, or he gets, you know, 2 yards when it should have been a 2 yard loss. Look, he is a power back and a very compact. I mean, Zeke's what, 5'10 maybe? 5'10?
Is he even?
Solidly built, compact. Like you said, he's not that home run like at his sophomore year. When he ran wild the last 4 games of the season, he's not that back anymore, Skip. But don't look, would I be surprised that when it's all said and done, I look up, damn, 3 of the first 4 years, Zeke led the league in rushing. Would I be surprised? No.
Okay. Zeke has the best body lean of any back I've ever seen in all the years I've covered and watched pro football. And body lean is willpower. It's fearless, because to have the body lean he has, you're going to have to take a bunch of big hits right in the mouth.
Right.
He takes a bunch of them.
Right.
I don't see the body lean from Saquon. In his mind, he's more of a breakaway back.
Right.
So if you ask him to establish the run between the tackles, he doesn't run as hard between the tackles as he does off the edge.
Well, normally he's having to juke like 3 people to get out the backfield.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, they've already let the line. I mean, Skip, the thing is, when you look at Barry did have Pro Bowl linemen, his center Glove and his left tackle Lo Brown. They were Pro Bowlers.
I'd say.
What guy from the Giants going to the Pro Bowl on that offensive line? They lucky to have jobs next year.
What's his name? Will Hernandez. He talks a Pro Bowl game.
Oh, he getting into it.
He swings a Pro Bowl game.
You know what, Skip? He one of those guys, you see him, I see this type that he is. He pushing and shoving on every play. Huh. He just happy to be there. Mm. He having, you know, I'm just going, you know, he getting in a fight with everybody.
Yep.
He and Quinn getting into it. And somehow he on the side, he and Jalen Smith getting
into it. Well, at one point he started it with Xavier Woods, and Xavier got the flag. And I don't even know what it was for, but he shoved him.
Yeah, and then Jalen Smith saw it. He came and shoved him, and I'm glad they didn't throw a flag. Yeah. I mean, but look, these are two outstanding backs. But you say, okay, Shannon, you get one, and we're going to put them on equal footing. I'm taking Saquon.
I'll take Zeke because I can win more games with Zeke.
Yeah, and that's it.
Where you might get me is, I don't know how long Zeke's going to last.
Flip him.
Okay?
Put Saquon behind Dallas line, put Zeke behind the Giants.
I don't know.
Yeah, I know.
I wouldn't love it.
I would love it. Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Oh, that kid going for $2,000. Mm. He going for $2,000. Because, Skip, some of those runs you say, Zeke, get going. Mm-hmm. He gone.
Mm. And by the way, last quick point about Barry Sanders. Mm-hmm. Remember, goal line, short yardage, they took him out of the game, just for the record.
Right.
And that's almost what you have to do with Saquon, because I don't see him bull for a yard on 3rd and 1. I don't see him doing that.
But with Barry, all the time he done juke like 5 people in the backfield, he might have had 20,000 yards. If you add up all the yards that he lost because he had to juke like 15 people, he probably got $20,000.
Mm.
Good to note, though, since returning from that injury, he's failed to reach 75 yards in his last 3 games. So maybe he's still not feeling 100%, Saquon?
Well, that quarterback.
That's possible.
I mean, it's...
That quarterback play.
So if you're mentioning the quarterback play, that means that Dak must have had a pretty good game yesterday as well.
He did all right.
Oh, how about we talk about Dak, shall we? Let's break down the...